All right, good morning, Monty. Morning. My name is Julie, and I'm going to take you through service today. It's going to be an awesome service. The energy in here is so amazing. We are just so excited to just have a beautiful experience today. The sun is out. We had a wonderful meditation. So I'm just really welcoming you here to the space, and also those of you who are joining us online. Thank you for joining us, and I'm going to turn it over to Mitch.
Good morning, everyone. I think I quoted Mother Teresa last time I was up here. God never gives us more than we can handle. Just wish God wouldn't trust me so much. So I will get to lead us in our morning sing-along. We're going to do sing-along. And it's one of my favorite songs, and we're going to have the lyrics pop up here in a second. And I'm going to invite Nicole Andrew and Charlotte to come join us so we can all sing together and raise the vibration and open this service. All right, so here are the words, and if you feel like standing and singing, please do. We're going to lift the vibration, and we're going to do joy, peace, and love. So it starts out with, this joy of mine, the world didn't give it to me. This joy of mine, the world didn't give it to me. This joy of mine, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away. Now we're gonna do peace. This peace of mine, the world didn't give it to me. This peace of mine, the world didn't give it to me. This peace of mine, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away. Let's do love. This love of mine, the world didn't give it to me. This love of mine, the world didn't give it to me. This love of mine, the world didn't give it to me. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away. One more time. The world didn't give it, the world can't take it away. Yes! Good job, everybody. Thank you, Nicole and Charlotte.
All right. Those of you online, I wish you were here to feel the vibration in the space right now. It's so cool. So cool. So awesome. Thank you. Thank you again, our trio this morning. Awesome. All right. So we are going to release the kids. So if we have kids that are going to go off and do their thing, and then they're going to join us at the end and share with us what they learned, what they processed, the gems that our kids can come to us with. So out of the mouths of babes, right? All right. All right, so welcome to the, Monty, we are so glad you're here. We wouldn't be here if you weren't here, kind of thing. So glad you're here, so glad you're joining us. And we are a spiritual center, as you know, we're here Sunday morning having this beautiful Sunday experience. And this is why we are all here. So let's just really, you know, infuse these words with some beautiful energy, because this is true for every single one of us. This is our vision. Let's do it together. Lighting the path to peace together. We couldn't do it on our own as well as we can do it together, and we are lighting that path to peace. We do this in very, very beautiful ways, so I'm so, so glad that you're here. So this is our mission statement. Let's go through this together as well, because it is also a very powerful statement that we are living into. Ready? So we are here to improve, empowering communities to learn and grow in a loving, innovative, spiritually based community. See, I'm all kind of tingly, so I had a hard time starting that myself. So appreciate your patience. Anyway, here we go. Let's just really understand that this is what we stand for. This is what we live into. This is who we are. And it is just beautiful to be here. Again, I'm all tingly, just excited to be here today. So I'd like to welcome any new people, if there's anybody new. I can't really see that well, so as many of you know. So if anybody new is here, we have our greeters, we have our folks who will give you something wonderful that you can take with you. And so you can be more inspired and really understand what we are about. So to just kind of take something home and have that clarity about what we do here. Oh my God, so I love the puppy. So we are just so excited. Again, so infused with joy, like that puppy. So one of the things that we offer as a spiritual community, and there are several of us here today that have had this beautiful training, we would love to sit and engage in affirmative prayer with you. And the way we do that is through just really reminding you who you are as this divine soul on this planet, just remembering the truth about you, reminding you of that truth. So if you want to bring something amazing and wonderful and new into your life, or you are interested in kind of cleaning house and letting go of things that aren't really supporting you, or anything in between, anything that you just are seeking some kind of like a pump to, an infusion of beautiful energy to, come and see one of us. Those of us who are trained to be practitioners or would love to do affirmative prayer, raise your hand, stand up, make some noise. However you want to do this, just draw attention to yourself. We are here. Just come and reach out. I'll be sitting here at the end of service. So if you guys want to come and join me and we can talk, we can just get into that place where we just affirm the truth about you. And when we do this as practitioners, we infuse ourselves with joy as well. So it is a beautiful gift that we love to share with you. Okay, so let's get into our announcements. Mitch, can you come and do announcements?
I'd be happy to.
Thank you.
All right. So announcements. We have a few things going on here at the Imani Center. As you can see today, I'll be speaking. And next week, we'll have Reverend Sherry. And then at the end of the month, we will have ministerial intern Kathy Wilson. So please make sure you show up for her. Yoga, we have some yoga practice. I love this yoga because it's not the like super you have to be like really great at yoga person. You can like wherever you are, you can come join us. We also have gentle chair yoga going on, and our yoga is for gentle chair. It's Tuesdays at 11:30 and then the Wednesday at 10:30. And who loves karaoke? Any karaoke in the house? This Friday, I'm going to be there. Hey, Steve, you going to be there? Going to be there. Nicole's going to be there. Charlotte's going to be there. 6 p.m. Come join us. Lift your spirit with song. Hey, you don't have to sing. You can just laugh at me and sing with me. It'll be good. What do we got next? Oh, classes. Love and Law, that just began, but people can still join, correct? Yeah. We'll have Yuli come talk about Love and Law. You're teaching that, right?
All right, so I'm teaching Love and Law, and what I love about that class is we are, so if you guys, those of you who read Ernest Holmes, he can be a little interesting, a little intense, and that's great. But what we do in Love and Law is we bring the love into it. We bring the tenderness into it. We bring the kind of that energy of love into it. And so we had one class this last week, and it was just awesome. There's a recording to it if you want to see what we hear, what we kind of talked about, what we went through, and this week we're not meeting, so if you join us, you've only missed one, and then you have some time to kind of catch up. We have only done the first two chapters, so it's really neat, and it's Ernest Holmes in his lectures, and so you get him in this more kind of intimate, passionate, beautiful space. And so come join us, and our first class will be the following Tuesday, not this Tuesday, so come join us.
Ernest Holmes, he was asked towards the end of his career if he would have done anything differently, and he said, yes, I would have focused less on the law and more on love. So come join this class. You're going to have a good time. We have Awareness 3 that's happening at 6 o'clock. Taming Your Inner Critic. Anybody want to tame their inner critic? Yeah, I'm teaching that today after service. Do you know there's 7 types of inner critic? I know, one's bad enough. But we're going to spend about an hour and a half. We're going to play with our inner critic, find out your top types, and then some tools and strategies for your type. It says here 12:30, so it'll be around 12:30 that we'll get started. It'll go for an hour and a half. Love offering. So you can get past your inner critic and won't tell you that you can't afford it. So there you go. Power of Prayer is going to be led by our own Reverend Pixie DeFour, starting April 17th, which is, I believe, Monday. So tomorrow, 6 o'clock. And then Rise and Speak. So this is something that I teach. I help you take your life, what I call your mess, and make it your message. Who's been to Rise and Speak? Anybody? Yeah. Really powerful class. I kind of feel like if God put me on the planet to do one thing, it's this. I have seen more healing, more unfolding and grace happen in this program than anything I've ever done, put together, or been a part of. So if this speaks to you, you have a question, come see me after it starts this Thursday. What do we got? Is that it? Any other? Yeah, okay. Silence your cell phones, put them on stun.
Okay, so it's now time to take us into a spiritual place, to really be in that place of feeling the blessing of being here, of just being on this planet, coming together as one in this space, just taking a moment, just eyes closed or open, however you want to do it, and just my words becoming your words, knowing that there is a blessing in this service, that the music, the speaker, the meditations, all of this just touches your soul. It is something that you feel the blessing in, that we just move smoothly and gracefully through this day, and we take this message, this core feeling, this essence of what we have here at Imani, such a very special sanctuary that we are blessed to be in. And we know that this is just who we really are, who we are here, how we unfold, and who we become slowly, effortlessly. It is a blessing, and we feel that blessing within ourselves. So from this place of blessing, we're going into the affirmation for today. So our affirmation comes to us from our ministerial intern, Mitch Austin. So I'm going to invite you to stand up as we go through this. And if you at home, you can do as you wish. We're going to take this three times. You're going to do it with me verbally twice. The first time with energy and enthusiasm. The second one, join me in a whisper. And the third time, please join me mentally. And each time, you feel it just coming deeper and deeper into your spirit. Let's begin. I turn over every concern, trouble, issue, doubt, and disease to the universal truth and intelligence that is life. I let it be and I let it go, knowing that I am fully held, guided, and supported in all that I am and all that I do. And so it is. I turn over every concern, trouble, issue, doubt, and disease to the universal truth and intelligence that is life. I let it be and I let it go, knowing that I am fully held, guided, and supported in all that I am and all that I do. And so it is. I turn over every concern, trouble, issue, doubt, and disease to the universal truth and intelligence that is life. I let it be and I let it go, knowing that I am fully held, guided, and supported in all that I am and all that I do. And so it is. You may be seated. All right. I'd like to invite our musical guest to share with us his first piece of music, Dalton. Let's give him a hand. Welcome. Thank you for being here. I asked him for an introduction earlier today. Didn't get much of anything, but his beautiful essence, I love his energy. So, and he's a fur dad, right?
Yep, and then plant dad.
And a plant dad. That's what I told so, her. You know, just let's enjoy what you bring, and thank you for being here.
Thank you very much.
Hello, everyone. Thank you.
that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing, hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. Well, she tied you to a kitchen chair, broke your throat and cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Well, the faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, her beauty in the moonlight overthrew ya. But it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not someone who's seen the light. It's a cold in and a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah. But all I've ever learned from life was how to shoot somebody who outdrew ya. Well, it's not a cry that you hear at night. It's not someone who's seen the light. It's a cold in and a broken hallelujah.
Wow, just wow. Wow, okay. Oh, just need to take a breath. All right, it's time for our meditation, taking us, keeping in the sensation and the feeling and the vibration of the hallelujah. Move everything aside and just give yourself the gift of meditation this morning. Eyes open or closed. Just follow my words. taking a breath now. Just a slow, beautiful breath in. Release. Let's do this 2 more times. One more. Honoring that sacred place and within us, that space of vibrational hallelujah that we have within, that soul space, that piece of us that has never been harmed, that knows truth with a capital T. We now create the space and we turn the volume up on that part of us that knows who we are. And we turn the volume down on the chatter, the things that don't serve us. Going into your meditation with an openness to receive. Enjoy your meditation. Staying in this place of high consciousness, it is now time for our divine healing. Knowing that you have received something, that you have opened yourself up, bring to mind now something that needs to shift for you to bring that truth into more light, to have that be something that you experience always. We now know that we are spirit. We embrace that within us. And we embrace it in each other. We know that this is true for every single one of us, that we are walking expressions of the divine. And from that place, we affirm and know that goodness and light is our truth, that abundance and health and vitality is for us, that we experience the goodness that is our birthright all the time, that this is just how we live. We let go of all that doesn't serve, and we welcome the things that do. We welcome the elevation, the acknowledgement, the experience of that divine within. With our gratitude in our hearts, we know that these words are released into the universe, to the universal law, that they can only be fulfilled because God's every answer is yes. Letting go with gratitude in our hearts. Together we say, and so it is. I'd like to invite Dalton to come back up again.
It's been a while.
stars above you. You never need to doubt it. I'll make you so sure about it. God only knows what I'd be without you.
So thank you to my girlfriend Christina for saving my modesty, letting me know what's going on. So I want to start today's talk with a little bit of wisdom from Facebook. And I know what you're thinking, like, really? We can't escape social media? But here's what I figure. If you can't beat them, join them, right? And on my Facebook, I do spiritual posts all the time. And when I get one that's really hot, I like to share it with you. So you ready for this one? I posted this quote by David Hawkins. Got any David Hawkins fans in the room? Yeah, he wrote Power Versus Force. He also wrote a book, lesser known but very powerful book, called Letting Go. And it's not quite what you think it is. Like sometimes we think letting go is just about some situation or we're in transition and we need to let go. It's way deeper than that. It's about a spiritual principle and being able to let go and get in the flow. And we're going to talk more about that today. So as I was going through the book, I came across this really amazing quote. And I ended up getting 54 likes, but that isn't the big deal. Here's the big deal. I got 46 comments. That never happened. So it ignited a firestorm of discussion. So here's the quote. You ready for the quote? It says, if the kingdom of heaven is within us, why do we often feel like hell? That's a quote. That's written. And we got some really amazing responses, and I want to share just a few with you. So one response is, because we've closed ourselves off to it, meaning heaven, due to the illusion of separation. This is why quieting the mind via meditation is so crucial. Right? Another person said, because we still believe in the idea of separation and actively pursuing that. That's why we're in hell. Someone else said, any discomfort is brought to us by our personality. Sometimes something we learned, precepts, judgments. Our heaven is in our silence. Beautiful wisdom, yes? Somebody else said the dissonance between that we've been brainwashed to believe about ourselves and the true selves expressing fully in this lifetime. That's why we experience. Somebody else said, hell has the best music. That's what somebody else said. That's what somebody else said. A good friend of mine, he said, because we spend all our time being externally focused, judging others. That's a kind of hell, isn't it? Another person said, we create our own hell in our minds because we've stepped out of the flow of feeling and knowing our oneness, our inherent wholeness. Someone else said, probably because we grew up with a belief system that told us that heaven was a place we go to when we die. Then we get the fun adventure of moving out of that paradigm into the new one of heaven is within us and all around us. Somebody else said that hell is a state of mind and heaven is a state of grace. So many good responses. Feel free to check out my, there's 45, I can't read them all. But so this idea of heaven and hell and how do we shift on the inside to have a greater experience of heaven. So we're going to talk a little bit about that today. So who would like to worry less, stop struggling, and discover the how? Right, to everything you wanted. Yeah, we're going to sign up for that today. Great, we're going to talk about that. And the title of today's talk is Let Go and Get in the Flow. Because when you're in the flow, you can't be worried, right? You're not resisting all of that good, all of that heaven that's trying to get to you. And in the flow is the way, is the how to where we want to get to. So specifically, I'm going to focus on the barriers of our flow, the barrier of worry, the barrier of resistance, and the barrier of the struggle of the how. How do I do this? How do I fix it? How do I get there? And all of this worry, resistance, and how, it focuses on one key thing. The ringing of my phone so everybody can hear it. I didn't even follow my own rules. Look at that. But I'm not worried. I'm in the flow. It's okay. It all centers around control. There's this idea that we get indoctrinated into that if we can just control things, everything will be okay, right? If I was selling wands in the back that would allow you to control every outcome of every situation and person, who'd want to buy it? Tell the truth. You know you might want to buy it. But here's the truth. It isn't that we can't create conscious outcomes. It isn't that we can't manipulate conditions. The issue is sometimes the thing we want isn't always the thing we need. And that's why life is set up the way it is, so that we can enter into a space of co-creation with a presence, a power, an essence, life that is all-knowing, all-powerful, and all-loving, and knows you better than you know you. Anybody got a friend or a parent that knew you better than you know you sometimes? And here's the deal. When control is on our agenda, you can know that fear is at the steering wheel of your life. So when you're feeling that urge to control the situation, the person, or what's going on, I'm going to invite you to ask yourself, what am I afraid of? And am I willing to let go some of that control and step into partnership with a power for good that wants what I want, which is peace, wholeness, an experience of heaven on earth right now? Because when we can start to let go of that control, we enter into the flow, which is where all the wisdom, the power, and the supply of spirit is. I remember I took a class called Foundations, which is oftentimes the first class you take in what's called the science of mind. Anybody take Foundations in here? Few people probably did. And Science of Mind was written by Ernest Holmes, and he was one of the New Thought leaders and pioneers. And so in the class, you learn about affirmative prayer, and you learn about this partnership, this co-creative dance, and to trust life and its timing, even though you want to control the situation. And in the class, we got prayer partners. And my prayer partner was complaining to me that she really wanted her, she had put down a deposit for her wedding on this place, and they had the wedding, and they were supposed to get the money back. And she's like, I don't know what's taking so long. We have this trip plan, we're going to use that money, and the money's not coming. And I said, well, maybe you're in a partnership of divine timing, right? Maybe let's entertain this idea, right, that there's something else at play. And then 3 weeks later, we were meeting again before class like we always did. And she goes, oh, my deposit came back. And she goes, and I'm so glad it came back at this time because my car just broke down. And now she was able to use the deposit. It would have been gone had it showed up any sooner. But sometimes we pray and wish and pull for things that really aren't in our best interest. See, there's this almost counterintuitive relationship to things that we're wanting to call in or how we're wanting things to shift and what we think we need to do about it. And the more we grasp, worry, pull, or try to figure it out, the more we push it away. It's actually a law. Alan Watts, who's a mystic, an author, luminary, he calls it the backwards law. He says when you try to float, you sink. When you try to be strong and you're stiff, you're actually weak. You're much stronger when you're flexible and you're open, right? And this is true with letting go. When we're letting go of things we're trying to make happen, it just shows up. It's this backwards law that we can embrace when we let go. So the three areas that I want to focus on so we can activate this is worry, resistance, and the how. And so I'm going to start with worry. So I said I had 5 hours sleep. Well, this is part why. I woke up at 3 a.m. and what was I doing? I was worrying. And I thought, oh, this is good. This is good. Here I am worrying at 3 a.m. and I'm talking about letting go. So how am I going to do it? How am I going to let go of worry? And I thought about a particular tool, and I did it. And I'm going to share that tool with you in a second. But I also thought about the Dalai Lama. Here's what the Dalai Lama says about worry. He says, if it can be solved, there's no need to worry. And if it can't be solved, worry is of no use. And I thought about that. And as I began to contemplate that, I went, you know, he's got a point. And worry is just keeping me up. So what can I do with this worry? And then I remembered a tool from Emmett Fox. Emmett Fox wrote a little book called The Golden Key. Anybody hate reading in here? You can't read like big books. It's like this bit. It's 8 pages. You can get it on Amazon, and it's brilliant, brilliant tool. I thought, I'm going to use the golden key for this worry. And here's the golden key. All you do is you take your mind off of the thing, the problem, the worry, the person, and you put it on God. That's it. That's all you do. And so I said to myself, I'm going to golden key this worry, this thing I'm worrying about. And what I like to do is I pick one of the 7 aspects of God, and I chose love. I'm going to golden key this with love. And then all I thought about was love. And before I knew it, boom, I was asleep. And when you start to put your mind on God and all the attributes of God, peace, love, courage, flow, power, your vibration changes. That's the trick. David Hawkins, in the book Letting Go, he addresses our role of the mind and how it affects our worry state. He says, the mind is a monkey jumping from tree to tree. Our mind jumps from thought to thought, and it's always looking for the next thing to worry about. And when you can catch your mind doing this, you can activate another tool, a meditation, an affirmation, or maybe the golden key. Because here's the thing. Our worries are really a prayer for what we don't want. Energy flows where attention goes. I remember hearing an example of this principle when I was listening to Wayne Dyer, and he was talking about Deepak Chopra, his good buddy Deepak Chopra. And Deepak was sharing a story with him when he was in medical school, and actually when he graduated and he was, you know, doing his medical practice, and he had a colleague of many years who came to him and said, I'm a little worried, I have to go get a physical. And well, I haven't had a physical in like 20 years. I know a doctor, not having a physical. It's kind of ironic. And he went for his physical. He needed to have a physical because he was going to get this health insurance policy, and they required a physical. So he went for the physical, and they did a chest x-ray, and they found a black mark on his lung. And Deepak's friend kept coming to him, and he was really worried. He was up at night. He couldn't sleep. And he was getting sicker and sicker and sicker. And in 4 months, he died. And when Deepak was cleaning out his friend, his colleague's desk, he found some old films of when they were in medical school, and it was a chest x-ray, and that chest x-ray showed the same black mark. He had had it for years and was living with it peacefully. But worry started to activate the energy and move things into a place that caused greater sickness and disease that didn't have to be there. So when we're golden keying, I like to use affirmations too. So here's one we can use. I turn this worry over to a power and intelligence greater than I am. And I know all is well. And I was doing that all morning for this talk. I know all is well. The second thing I want to talk about is letting go of resistance. When we're resisting what is, when we're pushing so hard against it, we create a counterflow for our good. But if we step into acceptance of what is, then all manner of good can flow with us. David Hawkins says, the state of acceptance is when you're happy about what is. I know you're thinking, really, Mitch? I just paid my taxes. Not too happy about that. And there are degrees of happiness. He goes on to say, acceptance is a big step. It means you stop trying to change others and yourself. It means you stop blaming yourself for things that are out of your control. See, there's an ease and peace that comes with acceptance, and now you're vibrating at a different level. But I get it. We're metaphysicians. We like law of attraction, right? We like vision boards. We want to make things happen, and that's not bad. But sometimes we're activating the backwards law by grasping too hard, focusing too much on it. Example I have of this is, for years, I had been over 200 pounds. I've been wanting to lose weight. And I would try a diet, I would do walking, I would do different things, I would do all these half measures, and if I was lucky, I'd lose maybe 15 pounds. That was a big victory. Then I had a situation where I wanted to focus on improving my health, and I had just let go of the whole weight idea. I'm like, I am what I am, right? I just let it go. And so I started focusing on upping my energy, drinking water, and doing all these things over here, and all of a sudden I lose 40 pounds. See, the minute I let go and I stepped into the acceptance and I just let it be, now all of that intention that I had built up, you know, the Hicks, you built it up in the vortex, it could all come through because I wasn't pushing so hard and collapsing down the flow of my good that was trying to get to me. David Hawkins says, when we stop we got any parents in the house? Parents? Okay, this is for you right here. This one's right here for you. When we stop expecting others to be a certain way, we create an opening for them to be that way that we really want them to be. I'm going to say that again. When we stop expecting others to be a certain way, we create an opening for them to be that way. I remember when I was in high school, I think my mother knew this. I told her I wanted to dye my hair half blonde and half black. Now, this was the 80s. She was not happy about it. You know, she wore her Liz Claiborne. She liked classical music. And here I come. I'm going to do this. And, you know, she turned to me and she said, okay. I'm like, oh. I didn't do it. She took all of the energy out of it. He goes on to say, when we stop expecting ourselves to be a certain way, we create an opening for ourselves to be that way. I let go of whatever size pants I was wearing. I just let it be. And then it showed up. So maybe it's not always about the decisions and the pushing and the planning. Maybe it's more about trusting life. Here's what Michael Singer says. He says, there are no decisions. There is only interaction with what is right in front of you. Decisions come because you have attachments, desires, fears. The only thing that will help you is to let go. If you let go of your stuff, there are no decisions. There is only life. Capital L, life. Fully supported, fully sourced, fully intelligent. I don't think the birds that are building nests right now are going, we need to decide we're going to build a nest, and which tree should we be in? No! They just are in that stream of life and letting it happen. The last thing I want to talk about is the dreaded how. The dreaded how. I do spiritual counseling, and so often people are coming in with, I need to know how. And then I go, no, you don't. That's not your lane. Your lane is the what. You are co-creators. Don't you know ye are gods? When Jesus said that, what Jesus was saying is you're a creator. You have the word, and the word is creative, and you'd state your what. And you are in partnership with God, which delivers the how. All the wisdom, all the source, all the supply, all of the vehicle delivery mechanism for it to show up. You don't need to know the how. The next time you catch yourself going, I do it, but I don't know how, put a pin in it. Because you're not telling the truth. You just need to begin. And you know, we come into the world and we know this. This is our standard operating programming. Just ask any four-year-old, can you sing? Yeah. Can you draw a cat? Sure. Can you juggle? Yeah. And all the balls are hitting the ground. They know they can do it. But there's this process of life that begins to tell us things, that inner critic, self-awareness. So you go from 4, I can do everything, which is the high truth, to 14. If you go into a room full of 14-year-olds and you say, who can sing? Good luck getting a hand up. Or who can draw? Or who can dance? Already indoctrinated in those limiting beliefs. But the magic is when we begin. You know, the Taming Your Inner Critic workshop that I teach, I started that workshop 8 years ago. And I want to be perfectly clear. I did not know how to do that workshop. But I knew I was called to do it. And so I started. And now it's one of the most powerful things I teach because I was in co-creation. That was my what? And the house started showing up. Rise and speak. Rise and speak. When I first offered that class and I booked it, I had no curriculum. I know, I'm telling on myself. But every morning at 6 a.m., I'd start and I'd commune with spirit and I'd ask what is needed. And then I'd listen, and then I'd, you know, go to the place of all knowledge, Google, and it would give me all kinds of tools and information, and then I'd put the curriculum together that night, and I'd do it again and again and again, and at the end, everyone who was in my first class, every one of them got up and spoke, and it was beautiful. I didn't do that. I was in partnership with the divine. You know, I'm writing a book. I am. It's called Winning Ugly, Unconventional Strategies for Uncommon Success. And when I started the book, I'm like, I don't have an editor, right? I could have went into I don't have an editor, I don't have time. But I just began because I know there's magic in these beginnings. I let go of the how. And then the editor showed up. A friend of mine, I forgot she did editing. And then I'm like, oh, how am I going to finance? Well, somebody tithed me $300 to help with the book. See, this is the kind of flow and dance that's available to all of us. So I want everyone to turn to somebody and say, let go and let God, right now. Turn to somebody and say, let go and let God. Turn to somebody else, let go and let God. Let go and let God. Let go, let go, let go and let God. Because heaven is on earth right now. All matter of supply, all matter of flow is here. And when we're in the flow, we feel a certain kind of peace, don't we? That's what we really want. We never want the thing for the thing, by the way. We never want the house or the partner or the 40 pounds off for the thing. We want it for how it makes us feel. That state of grace, we want to live in that state. And peace, peace of mind. And I'll wrap up with David Hawkins' final kind of comment on this. He says, when you reach peace, there is no more conflict, negativity, or anything bad. There is no good or bad, just peace. You feel a sense of calm. There is no time, so you don't have to worry about anything. You feel like you're one with everything, and you feel free. And that's my prayer for each and every person here today and online. As you find your peace, you find your freedom, you find your heaven on earth. Thank you so much. Blessed be.
All right, one more time from Mitch. I know I needed to hear that. Isn't it amazing how every time we show up and there's a speaker, it's exactly what you need to hear? Yeah. All right. It is. And so that's where we're just going to talk about it. It's a time for kind of having a conversation about this place, this beautiful place where we have beautiful speakers and wonderful karaoke and you know, all these different events and things that we do. And we're just so very blessed to be here and to just have this space for us to come and commune and just take joy. So I welcome you to kind of just think about that givingness, that sharingness that we have so that we can make talks like this and music like Dalton and all the different ways that we come together possible. And so just be in that space, knowing that you can do this. There's many, many different ways that you can support what we do here. Support your sanctuary, support our sanctuary. Allow us to continue to share the messages that we have that are our truth. And there aren't a lot of places where we can have these conversations. So let's just be in that blessing of knowing that this is happening so we can do it. You can go online. You can send us something in the mail, a check in the mail, those of you joining us online from wherever you are. We can do it the old-fashioned way. We can do it the, you know, technical way. So there are many different ways that you can share with us some of your abundance, knowing that as you create your own abundance, as you share this energy with us, that it comes back to you and all of us. It is circular, and it is beautiful to behold your time, your cash, your money, however you can support what we do here, just to, you know, to allow us to continue to be in the space together. So let's take your tithes, or if you are giving online, there's in front of you, there should be a in some of the chairs, there's a placard that you can take. You can put it to your heart, or you can just put your hands to your heart, knowing that this donation, this money, this tithe that you share with us is holy and beautiful and sacred. We know that you and I, we are all just in this place of flow, that we just take this all in, knowing that we are gifted over and over again through this exchange of energy. We are blessed beyond measure to be here, to hear these words, to hear the talks and the music and the blessings just continue to unfold for every single one of us. With deep gratitude, we let these words go, knowing that this abundance, this grace, this beauty is just part of our everyday existence. And together we say, and so it is. All right, Dalton, one more time.
Rose and flows of angel hair and ice cream castles in the air. Feather canyons everywhere. I've looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun, the rain and snow on everyone. So many things I'd wish I'd done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's clouds' illusions I know. I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel. Every fairy tale comes true. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go. If you care, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and steal somehow. It's love's illusions I hold. I really don't know love. Tears and fears and feeling proud to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes in circus crowds, since I've looked at life that way. But now, old friends, they're acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something's gained in living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's life's illusions I recall. I really don't know life. I've looked at life from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's life's illusions I.
Wow, that's all I got. Whew. Yes, I think we want Dalton to come back, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Woo. Yes, yes, yes. We have all spoken, so that's going to happen. Yes, definitely. All right, so whew, in this place of deep gratitude, I release these tithes knowing that they are pressed down, multiplied for all of our goodness, that they are unfolding in beautiful and amazing in unpredictable ways. We don't get caught up in the how. We just know that we welcome the beautiful abundance that is our birthright. And together we say, and so it is.
Yeah, kids.
All right, can we bring in the kids? Where are the kids?
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
So, hey, so, hey, you want to tell us what you guys, what you did today? You're not shy.
I'll try to get her to say something. Because I know you guys enjoy Charlotte talking instead of me. Anyway, I'm Nicole Andrews, secretary to the board at the Imani Center, and also help with the Kids Club. This is my daughter, Charlotte, who loves it here as well. I brought a book today called Taste Your Words, and if you can imagine, there's a little girl in this book who goes through kind of an adventure throughout her day. Her mom gives her the analogy of when you speak something, your words taste like something. So if you say something negative, tastes yucky like sour milk or rotten eggs or something along those lines, and then all of the beautiful words that we speak, like love, compassion, kindness, nice things that we say to each other, our siblings, our friends, etc., they taste like bubblegum and ice cream and chocolate, all the things that we love. So what Charlotte and I did today was make kind of little hanging placards that have words on them or affirmations on them that we can look at every day that help us taste the good things, right? So Charlotte, do you want to read what you have on yours? And I also want to say that I am really grateful for this. This may have been in my awareness at Charlotte's age, but it wasn't something that I went to every Sunday. Let me just say that. And if I would have had this at Charlotte's age, she's 7, life would be different. And these affirmations that she wrote on here, completely unprompted, this came from her. So can you read them for us? And she will read these each day. Says, you are amazing.
You can do it.
No, I know.
I don't want to. All right, so the first one is, you are amazing. Nothing can stop you. Be yourself and do what your heart does. Yeah. And, you know, usually we have other kiddos here, so Charlotte's a little bit sad. So it was another wonderful opportunity for us to just kind of embrace, you know, there's room for what is, right? And not every moment is happy, go lucky, joyful, and all of it has value, right? And next weekend, there will be tons of kids here. Let's affirm it now. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Charlotte. Thank you. Thank you, Nicole. All right, I'm going to ask Mitch to come up here because I don't know. I don't sing.
Can we please give a big hand to Nicole Andrews? Thank you so much for holding up the Children's Church. And please encourage families to come. We really love having that every Sunday. So one quick announcement that I forgot was everyone needs to mark their calendar for May 19th. We're going to do a Monty Live out in the parking lot with Random Strangers, the band. And we're going to have some other goodies. We're looking to have some craft vendors. We're going to do some raffles and make it a fundraiser for the center. And if you're interested in helping, we do need volunteers. Please see Kathy Clark Amos in the back. She'll have a little sheet. And we promise it won't be hard. We won't make you do everything, but we do need some help for that event. Again, May 19th. And also, if you're doing Inner Critic, we're going to circle up here after. We need at least 6 people. So if you're on the bubble, please consider coming and joining us. We're going to have a good time. And now we're ready to close. I'm singing again. I get to sing all day. So please rise, if you can, as we sing our closing song. And here we go. The presence is here. The presence is here. Love and spirit prevail on each face. The presence is here. Amen, the presence is here, and I will meet you in grace. I will meet you in grace. And as we go out upon our week, let us let go of the worry and the resistance and all of the monkey mind thoughts and feelings and lean in to good, lean into God, lean into spirit. And together we say, and so it is. Blessed be.